There's a place in your heart nobody's been.
Take me there. Things nobody knows, not even your friends. Take me there. Tell me about your mom.
At one ceremony, the preacher stated, marriage is not easy. but it is ordained by God. With that in mind, I will ask you both a question, and if the answer is yes, answer, I will. Terry, will you love this woman and, forsaking all others, become her husband today? Now you will. Will you love this man and, forsaking all others, become his wife today? The New Testament has a special group of verses that most people share at a wedding. In 1 Corinthians 13, the Apostle Paul writes, "Though I speak with the tongues of men and angels, but have not love, I have nothing. I have become sounding brass or a clanging cymbal. And though I have the gifts of prophecy and understanding all mysteries and all knowledge, and though I have all faith, so that I could remove mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. And though I bestow all my goods to feed the poor, and though I give my body to be burned, but have not love, it profits me nothing. Love suffers long and is kind. Love does not envy. Love does not parade itself. It is not puffed up. Does not behave rudely. Does not seek its own. Is not provoked. Thinks no evil. Love does not rejoice in iniquity, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. But whether there are prophecies, they will fail. Whether there are tongues, they will cease. Whether there is knowledge, it will vanish away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part. But when that which is perfect is come, then that which is in part will be done away. When I was a child, I spoke as a child. I understood as a child. I thought as a child. But when I became a man, I put away childish things. For now we see in a mirror dimly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, but then I shall know just also as I know. And now abide faith, hope, love, these three, but the greatest of these is love." To understand what Paul means about the love of Jesus Christ might seem like a mystery, but listen to what he really says. Love is that feeling where you put someone else's good in front of your own. That love is to be the motive behind everything else you do. The reason you feed the hungry, you have great knowledge, you give to the poor, you even risk your own life, that reason is true love. Love is patient and kind. It puts others first and is not rude. Love never fails. Finally, he says, "Now that you're all grown up, make this commitment to these three things: faith, hope, and love. And love is the most important of all." Are there rings to exchange? Let's pray. God bless these symbolic rings, never ending like their promises, pure like their love. Keep their wearers close to one another always. Amen. Now place this ring on his finger, saying, "With this ring, I do wed." And now place this ring on her finger, saying, "With this ring, I do wed." Today is as serious as life gets. You two are making promises that we all expect you both to keep. We're here to cheer you on, and we're here to support you as a couple. Now repeat after me, Terry first. "I, Terry, take you to love. To be my wife, for better or worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, as long as it goes shut. I, Joel, will take you, Terry.
I, Joel, will
take you, Terry. To be my husband, for better or worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, as long as it goes shut." Finally, I want to tell you how happy this day makes us all. You are now family, and we will pray for you guys all. There are only two more things to do. First, do you, Terry, take Joelle to be your lawfully wedded wife, to have in the hold from this day forward till death do you part? And do you, Joelle, take Terry to be your lawfully wedded husband, to have in the hold from this day forward till death do you part?
Yes, I do.
Now, second, since you both have made these promises and understand how serious this beautiful wedding is, I now pronounce you husband and wife. What God has joined together, let no one put asunder. You may kiss the bride.
Sugar. are my candy girl, and you got me wanting you, honey. Oh, sugar, sugar.
All right, Dad. Come true, it can happen to you if you're young at heart. For it's hard, you will find, to be narrow of mind if you're young at heart. You can go to extremes with impossible schemes. You can laugh when your dreams fall apart at the seams, and life gets more exciting with each passing day. And love is either in your heart or on its way. Don't you know that it's worth every treasure on earth to be young at heart? For as rich as you are, it's much better by far to be young at heart.
Well, this is to Terry. You have to forgive me for one thing, so I'm not used to this Terry. I'm not used to doing stuff like this, so if I say something, don't misinterpret it, and I just make the best of it. I've known Terry for a long time, and he's been a real good friend. He'd give you the shirt off his back, but if you tease him a little bit too far, he'll tell you about it. And he has nothing bad to say about any of his new family, or especially his new wife. And, I wish him the best of luck.
Yeah, we love her.
You better make it stick, because I ain't buying no more glue.
Happy as my second one has. happen at work, doesn't it?
Good luck.
No, I just hope you guys are very happy. Very happy now that it lasts.
Now, see, she's a lot nicer than him.
Hey, Terry, just remember, buy lots of chocolate.
Terry and Joellen, I wish you the very best and very, very long marriage together. Congratulations. Welcome to the family, Joellen. We love you.
Is this on?
Hi.
Is it on?
Mm-hmm.
Congratulations. I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful life with Mr. Terry Couch.
Say congratulations. Say we wish you the best, and yes, you can thank me for introducing you. No, seriously, we love you, and we wish you the best. Anything else? Tell me, you love
him? Reach the Turners at the end of the message. Leave a message or something.
Just so you know, if the pictures turned out crummy, Steve did it.
Whoa! Give me up. Give me a call. Bye.
What does...
What you want Uncle Buddy to know?
Oh, I just want to make fire robot car.
You what?
I just want to make the giant robot car.
Tell Uncle Buddy how to make his wife happy.
Okay.
No.
We wish you a happy life together. We love you. We love you.
What do you have to say, Jenny? What's your wedding advice?
Nothing.
Nothing?
No.
You should leave advice to Terry on how to deal with someone from this family. How do you do it? What's the magic trick?
Prozac.